So we get a kart racing movie on Netflix. The perfect sort of thing to take advantage of and encourage people into the sport. And now we're in the midst of a global pandemic and everyone's in quarantine. So that's a shame. Either way, I'm going to review it. I'm going to take a look at it. Let's see what this film's all about, whether it's any good and whether there's any sort of positives to take from it for karting as a whole when eventually and hopefully we get out of this situation. So, yeah, it's a new film out. I think Netflix picked it up a few months ago, but anybody that knows about karting would have seen the odd news report that there was an Aussie film being made. I think on Kart Sport News, must have been a year and a bit ago, there was a press release about the production company looking for people to, you know, be extras and be part of the film project. So, yeah, I'm not going to tell you too much about the plot, but it's pretty standard affair. Young kid finds out about karting, and then within a ridiculous amount of time is fighting for a national title. But there, what I wanted to talk about was not so much the plot, which is, you know, it's fair enough. Some of the good stuff from the film, if you're looking at it from a karting perspective. Sure, there's some cheesy stuff. Sure, there's kind of stuff that will be... There's like a... Like, when you watch films... There's not a word for it, but there should be. That when you watch a film and you're kind of an expert or knowledgeable about the subject, it's kind of excruciating to watch. But for everyone else, it's brilliant. I mean, you know, if you watch any motor racing movie, there's always the cliche changing down three gears halfway down a straight to overtake someone, or, you know, even something like, you know, so critically acclaimed as Whiplash.
Not quite my tempo.
Which is about jazz music. A lot of jazz musicians have gone through that particular system of education, cite so many errors with it that they struggle to watch it. So, you know, when you watch a film like this, it's always worth taking into account that people that are watching it that aren't involved in kart racing that we want to encourage in eventually won't really care about all of the little things that we notice. But, you know, first of all, you can clearly see that whoever made the film was inspired by Ayrton Senna. And if you look at the pictures, some of the promo pictures and stuff, you'll see, you know, the kit that the sort of kit that the kid wears, Jack Hooper, he's the star of the sort of the carter, the guy that gets into karting, his suit and his kart for some reason is sort of kind of podless, and we're obviously as carters watching it going, how did he get that through scrutineering? But there's something where you think, yeah, the guy that's made the film, obviously in the production process, was inspired by the pictures of Senna years ago. It's the yellow and the black and all that. So that's kind of cool in a way. You know, the kart would never pass scrutineering, but yeah, that's kind of funny. I think one of the best bits about the film was it was very karting centric. There was a girl in the film who is the daughter of a team boss who runs cars and karts, and she, I think her name in the film is Mandy. I could be wrong. I forget these things. But so she's the daughter of a team boss, and she's kind of, you know, she wants to get involved and the dad doesn't let her. And eventually, you know, she calls herself a chief engineer, which I've never heard in a karting paddock. But I think for the purposes of the film, it's kind of to elevate that position as someone that's a mechanic, rather than just being a mechanic, because she has aspirations. But yeah, the kind of good thing about the film was it was very karting centric in that there wasn't any references about going on to do Formula One, or apart from the girl with the mechanic who said she wanted to be, you know, a chief engineer in F1. But from a driving perspective, there's none of that. It's just a kid that wants to go karting. He likes it, and that's it. And I thought that was quite interesting. I think when you watch the film, and you might know a lot about karting, you might dismiss it, but I think as a central point, that's quite good. I think it's quite nice to have that, rather than having a kid going, I want to be an F1 driver, and it's all like, you got to start in karts, kid, and work your way through. You know, it's just a fun movie, and they don't hang around on that sign of F1 thing too much. One of the characters, Patrick. So Patrick is a guy that is basically the old sage, the Mr. Miyagi character, because they draw on Karate Kid a lot. And he runs this old sort of dirt cart track and lives in a caravan. And he must, you know, you infers that, you know, he was a cart driver in the past. And, you know, he's a bit grumpy and all that. And the one of the guys early on in the film goes, can you teach my kid? And he goes, no, because your kid's got no talent. Which you watch and you think, actually, I have seen people say that in the Kite and Paddle. That's not far from the truth. So that was quite cool. You know, for sure, there was a lot of things that you'll watch and you'll notice, like, you know, when he builds the cart up at first, it's got like I can't remember what engines they're running, like an old Yamaha or something. Anyway, then it changes to an IMEKA, and obviously they're not going to reference that because, you know, whatever. But there was another bit in the film, actually. It was quite funny when the kid turns, like, you're thinking, how does he get the cart to the circuit? You're asking all these questions, right? And how does he have the money to do it, even though they reference it being expensive? But there's a bit where he trailers his cart to the circuit and he's using his bike, push bike, to do it. And again, you're watching and go, that's ridiculous. But I do know someone, Will Dendy, who cycled his engine to the circuit. So sounds extreme, but he did. He did something as mad as that, or cycled his engine to his engine builder, then to the circuit. It's like one of these things that you hear and you just go, that's not real. But no, it these kind of things that look kind of unrealistic in the film are kind of have sort of, I do know that they kind of have happened in a roundabout way. So that was kind of cool. Yeah, I mean, acting wise, yeah, it's, you know, young teenagers. Fair enough. I'm not Mark Kermode. I'm not going to sit here and, you know, I'm not going to deconstruct it like a, I don't know, Tarkovsky film. So, but no, it was good. It was lighthearted. There was some genuinely funny things in it. I think if you're involved in karting, sure, you might think, oh God, this is cheesy and some of it's a bit off. But if you watch any movie you're not an expert in, I can guarantee someone that is an expert in it is sitting there cringing. Like, if you know, Top Gun is probably one of the best films ever made, but there'll be jet fighters watching it going, well, that's a breach of protocol. They'd never do that. Oh, that's not right. So, you know, you kind of have to watch it from a different perspective. So, you know, it's not the best film in the world. It's not going to win any Oscars, but yeah, I thought it was good. But it was all right. And, you know, we've got a lot of time to sit about and not do anything for a while. So, you know, maybe recommend it to a few mates. And maybe when we get back to the circuit this year or even next year, you know, at least we've got something that may encourage a few more people in. Unless sim racing, which is starting to thrive in this new environment, takes us all out. So, yeah, good little film. I can't complain too much. And I think that, you know, I thought it was all right. I thought the message that, you know, you find karting, you want to give karting a go. Sure, the kid went from a rookie to national in 4 weekends of racing, but, you know, it's a film and it's fun. And I don't think it's as bad as you might think it is. I got to the end and I am a stickler for movies. I'm a right arsehole. So if I don't like something, you know, I actually walked out of a screening of that Green Hell Nordschleife documentary, and I went to the cinema to watch that, and it wasn't helped because the bloke next to me was drunk and fell asleep, but I walked out of that, and I got to the end of this, so that says something. So thanks for watching, and thanks to all the patrons and everything. You know, hopefully you can stick with me while we go through this. I think by now you would have realised I didn't do the budget cart challenge. For now, what is obvious reasons, and it was hard to explain to people then. So anyway, thanks for everybody that's watching, and if you want to sign up to the Patreon page, you know, help me out, and even donate via PayPal, all that shabazz. So hopefully we can see each other soon at the track and get some of these projects finished. But yeah, let's all stay at home, don't do anything silly, listen to the advice, and let's not put any more people in hospital. Thanks for watching.